it's me again. In the last episode, we discussed anti-geometries. In this episode, I'll be talking about wheelbase, which is one of the actual ways to change the amount of load transfer in your car. So how this all works is when you will, again, look at the car from the side, you will have the point where you have the center of gravity, and then you have the front and the rear end, which are supporting your car from the ground. When the car accelerates or decelerates, the load on the tires will transfer. So let's say you have a 50-50 weight balance. Whilst you would be decelerating, you will have more load on the front tires. And when you're accelerating, you would transfer more load to the rear tires. Let's say 60-40 or even 70-30 or whatever. So the way wheelbase affects all this is you will change the amount of transferable force on a car at any given point. So with a longer wheelbase, you will have less transfer of force whilst you would be accelerating or decelerating, and vice versa with a shorter wheelbase. So this all comes down to the support lever factor in this. So longer wheelbase, longer support lever, less transfer of force front to back. Shorter wheelbase, shorter support lever, more transfer front to back. So now, what does this mean to your car when you're driving on the track? So let's say you're gonna have a shorter wheelbase. You have a shorter support lever, meaning you will have more load transfer whilst you're accelerating and decelerating. So if you're accelerating out of a corner with a shorter wheelbase, you will have more force from the front tires transferred on to the rear tires and give you slightly better grip while you're accelerating. With a longer wheelbase, you will have less of that load transfer to the rear, and that will give you slightly less grip. So another thing which I think is secondary in changing a wheelbase is the rotational axis. So if you think your car has a longer wheelbase, you will have to turn your front tires more or get your rear tires to slide to have the car go around a smaller turning radius. What this then means is with a longer wheelbase, you will obviously have the car rotate much less than with a shorter wheelbase. However, with the longer wheelbase, you will have much better control in very sweeping corners, high-speed corners, and just very open tracks in general. That's just because of the fact that you will have more support during your rotation, and you will have the car rotate less as a function of its wheelbase, and you will have more sort of feel on the steering because you're working in a different area. And this really, I think, is one of the other key factors apart from the load transfer on the tires that people really feel when they change their wheelbase. Now, we've gone through how the wheelbase affects the load transfer on the tires and also the turning radius function of changing a wheelbase. Now, I'll go through the things that I feel like wheelbase affects the most whilst on track and how I feel the car when I change this. So the biggest difference that comes to mind is on bumpy tracks, and this is for the strength of a longer wheelbase. Now, as you already know, having a longer wheelbase will give you less load transfer during acceleration or deceleration, and if you're driving on a bumpy track, you really want that, because let's say you're driving into a bump out of the corner and your car is trying to rotate and really is pushing the rear tires to the ground much harder, you will hit that bump also much harder. So longer wheelbase will give you that advantage in the bumpy tracks. And this will work when braking. And also, now if you think you're going through a sweeping corner and you have that longer rotational axis and you have more sort of security in the car and there's a bump there, not only will you have the benefit of having less load transfer during acceleration and deceleration, you will also have the car be a bit calmer in those scenarios when you're going high speed and turning and hitting a bump due to the fact that the car just doesn't want to rotate as much. This is why I generally always suggest people run a longer wheelbase when tracks are rough or bumpy. Now, when the tracks aren't bumpy and you have a really flat track and there isn't issues with the surface, you only have to think about the corners and braking and accelerating, you will want to have as long wheelbase as possible, as long as you will have a desired rotational axis. So let's think of it in the context of actually driving the car. So you will have a track with a lot of sharp corners, sort of like American style tracks where you have jumps and then you have a really sharp corner, pretty much only 180s or 90s. In this scenario, you don't really need to have that feel in a car doing a long corner or that security going through bumps. You will just need the car to turn around as fast as possible and hit the throttle again. And this is where shorter wheelbase should excel. Now come to tracks like in Europe, where you will have more sweeping corners, high speed, very rarely any 180s, and you just need to carry a lot of speed and keep the car in the right line. In this scenario, longer wheelbase will have pretty much all the benefits. So medium to high speed corners, on throttle corners, and places you will have to sort of feel the car and really drive it on its edge. Longer wheelbase will give you more room to work with, since the every time you hit the throttle or brake, the load transfer between the front and rear tires won't be as dramatic. Just to sum it up in one sentence, longer wheelbase, more stability, shorter wheelbase, more rotation. So now that we've sort of went through all of the ideas and the principles of how tuning your wheelbase works, so now let's look at some of the issues we have with tuning our wheelbase the way we tune it in our RC cars. So unless you're changing your chassis, you're most likely just changing your hub or arm position by shimming it differently. And if you do it so that you shorten the car from the rear or shorten the car from the front, you will have two effects. One is you will change the weight balance of the car, and two is you will change the drive shaft angle. So let's start out with weight balance. So as we went through in episode 10, changing a weight balance can do a lot of different things to the car. But generally, the case is when you have a front heavy car, the car will understeer. When you have a rear heavy car, the car will oversteer. And what I like to call the hammer effect, where the rear wing will just suddenly kick out. So let's say you will shorten a wheelbase in the rear. This will change the weight balance to the rear by quite much. Now, you will have all those effects that we talked about before, but you will still have the hammer effect, just that all those other effects sort of cancel it out. So in the rear, this is not really that big of an issue, but then in the front, a lot of the times, if you have a very 50-50 weight balance, actually shortening the wheelbase will make your car understeer a bit. And if you have a rearward bias, as probably most cars do have, having shortening your wheelbase in the front will most likely make your car turning a bit better. So this is something just to keep in mind, to really understand that, hey, I'm actually changing my weight balance as well, not only the wheelbase. And as I sort of explained there, the sort of wheelbase change most of the time overrules this weight balance change, but the point of this is just to show, know this when you change your car. There's still one issue even if you change the wheelbase on both ends, front and rear, to account for the weight balance change, and that is the drive shaft angle. So when you would tune your hub forward or rearwards, or armed forwards or rearwards, you will actually end up changing the angle of the drive shaft. This will change the amount of friction in the drive shaft whilst you're on power. And this will really have an effect on the car, even though you would not probably think about it at first. So really, if you want to tune only your wheelbase, you will have to tune it both in the front and the rear, and tune it by changing your chassis, not changing your hub shimming. So this is a much bigger topic than this, but just know that tuning your hub forwards or rearwards will have a lot of different effects than just the wheelbase. And the next episode will be about this friction in the drive shafts, because it's such a huge topic. Generally speaking, the only way to actually turn just your wheelbase is to have a different chassis that has both the front and the rear end shortened. A lot of these chassis that companies release are longer chassis, but from the rear. So what this actually does is it lengthens a wheelbase, but it also changes the weight bias towards the front. So one of the reasons why a lot of these manufacturers have better results with longer chassis is not actually the wheelbase per se, but the wheelbase combined with the weight balance shifted towards the front. And let's say most of these cars are probably slightly rear biased, so having that change towards the front will make their car much closer to 50-50. So this is also one thing to notice, that you can't just change the chassis on the rear, you would have to change the chassis on both front and rear. So there's so many variables here that you need to take into account and understand, and it really helps you to explain what's going on. But as I said, next episode will be about drive shaft angles and the friction in them, which is, in my opinion, one of the biggest variables here in tuning your wheelbase, apart from the actual wheelbase change. Alright, this was a fun video to think about, because a lot of these things I talk about are sort of connected, like roll centers and springs, or anti-geometries and wheelbase. That's why it's really hard to discuss these things on their own, but to try to understand all of them separately would be really difficult as well, because there's so many things to think about. But yeah, check out the next video, and if you watch it till the end, check out the previous episode as well, since all of these things sort of connect with each other. And to be honest, every video I'm talking about sort of connects to each other, because in the end, the car is one complex system. It's not different systems forming a car. It's a car that is a complex system on its own. But yeah, anyway, hope you liked the video. Like and subscribe, and see you next time. Alright, I hope you liked that video. If indeed I did actually help you out, please let me know by writing a comment down below. Also, if you like my type of content, feel free to like my Facebook page, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also share it with your friends in social media. Now, if you think I was wrong about something in this video, please let me know. I'll go through all the comments, and I'm really open to differing opinions, and I really want to just spark up a conversation. So, with all that, until next time.